Hey everyone, welcome to our deep dive on reNgine. Before we jump in, quick disclaimer. We're reviewing this GPL 3.0 license tool. We're not maintaining it. So check out Yogesh's GitHub for the official project. You can find a link in the description below. So let's talk pain points. If you're doing security assessments, you are probably juggling multiple recon tools. You have tools for finding subdomains, you have tools for checking DNS records, you have tools for looking at WAFs and CMFs and identifying what they are. So you are dealing with a lot of data from disparate sources, from all kinds of different places. And if you're working on a team, even if you're working on your own but with poor documentation, you may have a very different stack from engagement to engagement, or different members of the same team during the same engagement may have very different stacks, what kind of tools they're using, what kind of outputs they're getting. And that can mean that you spend a lot of time on manual tasks, kind of reconciling that data, getting it into the same place, being able to work on it or report on it. So the tool sprawl is real, and documentation, like I was saying, you may not have any. You may have some, it may not be up to date. We all know how documentation goes, for sure. So how can we deal with these problems? One way is with reNgine. So what is reNgine? reNgine is an open source security tool that combines recon, vuln assessment, and continuous monitoring. So we can figure out what our attack surface is, right? We can check for vulnerabilities, and we can set it up to do so on a recurring basis. We can set the periodicity by day of the week and time, or we can set it just on a recurring time frequency. So every hour, every day, every week, you know, whatever our needs are. And the key differentiator is that workflow engine lets us automate that entire assessment process. So from that initial scanning up to that final reporting, we are able to use this tool to dramatically speed up our process. Now, there are two main components here. There's the recon engine that handles everything from subdomain enumeration, like we were talking about earlier, to tech stack detection, like that CMS identify. And there is the vulnerability scanner, and that brings custom templates and supports multiple scanning engines. So you can set up what tools you want to have run with each of those scanning engines, and then it will correlate all of the data from those various tools and bring it into your dashboard automatically so that you can review those results. You can begin to work on your report, or you can work on more in-depth manual testing. If you see something that's interesting there and you want to see if you can escalate it into something that is more significant, right? But what used to take hours of manual work can now run in the background, and you're able to come back and review those results. Okay, so time investment wise, let's talk return on investment. With the traditional workflow, you're configuring multiple tools again and again and again. You're manually correlating the results from those tools, so the CSVs or JSONs or YAMLs or whatever kind of data that you're getting out of that. You got to bring it all together so that you can report on it. And then you're spending hours on that reporting process. So with reNgine, you're looking at one configuration, you set up your domains that you want to look at, your IP addresses that you want to look at, automated correlation, the results that come out of those tools, and then templated workflows. So if you want to add a new tool in and you want to run a specific subset of tools, you can do that, and you can segment that off and say, hey, I want this scan engine so that I can use this in every future engagement. You can save a lot of time. Your time can go into analysis and less tool management, right? So you can even come in here to scan engine, and you can modify the existing scan engines, or you can create new scan engines. So we can see what tools are being used here, whether it's going to crawl, how many threads it'll use, and how long it's going to wait to get its responses back for. So you can go through and set these up with a tremendous amount of customization, as well as you see the tool references up here, even adding in new tools. So if we go into tools arsenal, we can actually configure new tools here that will be invoked, or that we can invoke within those scan engines. So pretty cool stuff. So let's look at a cost analysis, right? The basic support at $345 a month will get you installation help, it'll get you bug fixes, it'll get you implementation assistance, and it will get you regular updates. So as soon as the reNgine official repository updates. We will also be updating our versions on AWS and Azure so that you are on the latest version. We also, as soon as Ubuntu updates their LTS version, update to the latest version of Ubuntu. And in our versions also have unattended upgrades with a special configuration to make sure that it is updating and pulling down security updates as soon as they come out. So the ROI for you there comes from hours saved per assessment and your increased capacity to perform assessments. So you're not having to mess around with setting up the concurrency settings, with setting up the Docker Compose, with managing those components, with managing updates to the OS. We handle that for you. And then if you get stuck and you're wondering, hey, how do I do this in reNgine? We're able to provide you with help there. You also don't need to do that. You can start with the community version, like we have the link to Yogesh's project below for free, and you can upgrade when or if you need support, right? So next, let's go ahead and do a live demo. Let me show you exactly how this works. So we'll create a template, we'll run a scan, we'll analyze the results, and we'll generate a report, and we'll take a quick look at the report. So watch how fast this is compared to traditional methods, right? So we will create our template. So here we are in reNgine. We can go ahead and we can add a new target. And we'll just scan the HailBytes site. All right, and no hacker one team target handle and no target organization here. Well, then we could put in HailBytes. And we will add one target here. And so with that, we now have our template set up and we can begin to initiate scans. We will run our scan. All right, so then we'll go back into our targets, right? So we have these templates for who we can scan. We'll go ahead and we'll initiate a scan. And in this case, we're going to go through and do a subdomain scan since we're going to scan our main blog site and like port-wise, it's going to be extremely, extremely few findings since it's just locked down to four ports. All right, so no other subdomains that we're going to feed in to start with, and we're going to have it discover those subdomains for us. All right, we'll start the scan, and then we'll come back in just a few minutes, grab some coffee, come back in just a few minutes, and we'll look at the results, and then we'll look at the report. All right, be right back. We will take a look at the results from this scan. All right, so we'll come back to our scan history here, and we can see that the subdomain scan completed. We go into view results. We can see it had quite a lot of findings, found 106 subdomains, which is accurate. That's going to be all of the different subdomains that we use on our blog for translation purposes. And then we can see it completed in 2 minutes. See the arguments that it was started with for running through. So subfinder running in here, providing the majority of the results here. And then when we want to report on it, we can go and then we will generate our report. All right. Go to scan history. And we can download the scan report. So we'll go ahead and pull modern template and download that report. And then we can go ahead and skim through this report. So this is going to be primarily listings of subdomains. Lots and lots of subdomains, lots of 403 forbidden, because Cloudflare was upset. Cloudflare and WordFence both would be upset about the scanning activity. Yep, and we see all 106 domains. And again, we see those ports open for just a few of these, as well as we see some of the translation delivery network IPs. So this French IP here, as well as this IP in the United States here. These are both the translation delivery network IPs, in addition to the Azure IPs that we see from before. Awesome. So how can we get started? Now, there are a lot of ways you can deploy reNgine, but we are going to look at just three. You can deploy via the cloud marketplace on AWS or Azure. Just go on the marketplace and search for reNgine. You can set it up self-hosted in AWS or Azure or your private lab or a VPS of your choosing, or you can set it up in a local Docker on the machine that you're working on right now. So we have different support tiers. to fit different needs, from community, where you're opening up GitHub issues and joining the community reNgine Discord, up to premium, where you're able to join our premium Discord and get responses within 2 business days, even on implementation issues that you're having, or if you want to know how to get specific tools in, you're trying to use specific LLM models for generating your reports, you have more in-depth questions like that, that is absolutely perfect. So our docs and the forums that we offer are comprehensive on top of the reNgine community docs. But the real gold is in our Discord community, where you can do screen shares or share screenshots or screen recordings of your issues and describe those and get resolution much faster because of being able to provide that supplementary information when you're trying to get support help. So in terms of next steps, if you're ready to try reNgine out, you can grab the community version from GitHub, or you can deploy via AWS or Azure Marketplace just by searching reNgine, like I was saying earlier. I would highly recommend joining our Discord. We're building a great community of security pros. We're sharing job posts. We're sharing workflows in reNgine, helping each other out with those types of implementation issues like I was talking about before. And you can drop into the help channel for any of the tools if you get stuck, so reNgine help, or you can share your custom workflows in the showcase channel, so reNgine-showcase. So please, if you like this video, like, subscribe to the channel for more content like this. We're going to do an AWS and Azure quick start video for reNgine soon, and then drop a comment on how you're going to use reNgine, right? We would love to know, and share this video with other professionals that could benefit from using reNgine, right? Thank you so much and good luck. Happy hunting.